this is that previous drawing that you saw, but this is the actual pieces put in place. So you can see the closest one to me here is actually the dosing tank. So coming in on the far left, that's our septic. We've got those hatches with the sanities in them. Everything flows to those three microfast units. And then after that, they drop into this dosing tank. And from there, we had about a 4-acre drip drain field. I didn't bring those photos because they're sort of not relevant. This is, our company is a kind of a family company. We're a woman-owned company. My wife is the owner. My sister is our residential manager, and we are actively looking for more women to work in our business. We have found that in our industry, there is a lot of women who are very interested in this process. One of our best service providers is a woman, and she wanted to be here, but we couldn't quite squeeze her in time. She's about the best out there. Women are, I find, more detailed than men when it comes to a lot of these technical aspects. So I strongly recommend you guys look towards that. This is another project that we did. This is a STAR 13.5. Again, this is another giant hole we had to blow in the ground in order to make this project work. The facility is a meat packing plant, and it's up on the hill to the left. And here are the Weezer tanks getting dropped in. There we go. This is sort of the, before we backfilled, this is what everything looked like. All the tanks in Idaho have got to be coated with foam. You need at least 2 inches over the top and down the sides in order to continue to receive any treatment. Otherwise, the water just gets too cold and we cannot produce the correct microbes to not only get our BODTSS, but in order to get our nitrogen, we really, really have to keep the warmth in there. These are our guys installing a STAR 13.5. They're down inside. I'm sure they're super excited to be seen by you guys. That's sort of the finish. When we're completely done, that's what the facility kind of looks like. Not my idea to build that wall so close on the left, but that system this winter was about under about 8 feet of snow. It's been a really wild winter for us in Idaho. Again, this is our guy setting the pumps in the STAR 13.5s, and then that's sort of the final product looking inside the tank. So those tanks are a 9,000-gallon tank. Each of those modules, three of them are a STAR 4.5. If you guys don't know how the STAR system works, when you get to the larger sizes, we utilize around an 9,000-gallon tank, and each module will give us about 4,500 gallons a day of treatment.